to Jesus.
Praise to the Trinitarian God.
Hallelujah.
Praise to the God the Father, God the Son, and God the Spirit.
Amen.
Yes. Praise to the one who came and died on the cross for the sin of mankind. Amen. Praise to the one by his blood who reconciled us to God.
Amen.
Praise to the Lord Jesus Christ. Christian scripture identifies us as sinners. Christian scripture identifies Jesus as eternal Son of God. Christian scripture identifies Jesus, God himself. Christian scripture tells us approximately 2,000 years ago, Lord Jesus Christ came to save the sinners, which we are all sinners.
Yes.
With his blood on the cross, when he nailed on the cross, with his blood, we are saved, we are redeemed from the wrath of God.
Yes.
Praise to the Lord Jesus Christ.
Praise be to Jesus.
As today, millions of people follow Lord Jesus Christ because of the teachings of Jesus. Also, approximately 1.84 billion Muslims follow someone called Muhammad. Someone called Muhammad. According to Islamic scripture, Muhammad is identified as the man who is mercy to the world. Muhammad is identified as a perfect example for individuals to follow. 1.84 billion people are following man called Muhammad. Now, we want to look at two examples from his life and then see if he is mercy to the world or if he is perfect example to mankind.
Yeah.
Our example comes around 620s when Muhammad goes to take over one of the Jewish tribes. He meets with someone called Kinana. Can you read us the story, brother?
Let's read this. Okay, so this is taken from Ibn Hisham, page 515. And it says...
It's one of the earliest biographies of Muhammad.
Yep.
Page 515 tells us how Muhammad was mercy to the world. Yeah,
let's see how merciful Muhammad is. Okay. So it says, Kinana al-Rabi, who had the custody of the treasure of Banu Nadir, was brought to the apostle who asked him about it. He denied that he knew where it was. A Jew came, Tabari says, was brought to the apostle and said that he had seen Kinana going round a certain ruin every morning, early. When the apostle said to Kinana, "Do you know that if we find you have it at Do you know that if we find you have it, I shall kill you?" He said, "Yes." The apostle gave orders that the ruin was to be excavated and some of the treasures was found. When he asked him about the rest, he refused to produce it. So the apostle gave orders to al-Zubayr, al-Awwam, torture him until you extract what he has. So he kindled a fire with flints and steel on his chest until he was nearly dead. Then the apostle delivered him to Mahmud bin Maslama, and he struck off his head in revenge for his brother Mahmud.
So let me break that down.
Yes, please do.
So Muhammad goes to the place
yes.
called Kaaba, which is approximately 95 miles outside of Medina.
Yes.
And then meets with a Jew man.
Yeah.
Who is the husband of Sophia.
Yeah.
Yet also this Jew man is also responsible for the treasure. What is treasure? You're English, so tell us what is it?
Treasure is what people consider as valuable. It could be, you know, pearls or stones or diamonds or lots of money. And so there's a lot of value
in
that.
Some It could be money.
Yeah.
It could be gold.
Yeah.
It has to be something valuable.
Yeah.
Okay?
Yeah.
So what Muhammad does is Muhammad wants to take that.
Yeah.
Muhammad wants to take this man's money, this man's treasure. Man doesn't want to give it. Muhammad asks him to tell us where the treasure is. They torch him until they find where the treasure is. Actually, they torch him until he tells people where the treasure is.
Mm.
How do Muhammad order torch to be? Is it, let's have a cup of tea and then you give us your money? Or is it, let me put fire on your chest, burn you, until you tell me where the money is?
Why don't you preach Jesus?
Until he's nearly dead.
Why are you talking about Muhammad?
Why don't you preach
Jesus? Because Muhammad is identified as mercy to the world.
He doesn't believe that. You don't believe that it's merciful.
Who torched people? I know Jesus, and I am sorry that you don't know Jesus.
Yeah.
I am sorry that you worship a man who torched people.
You crazy woman.
Money.
Why are you preaching against
you crazy woman?
So you're okay with Muhammad torturing
Allah
people for money? Are you okay with that? Because you asked the question.
I asked the question.
You came over. Right.
Preach what
okay,
Jesus
this is what Jesus taught. Jesus taught that he spoke. Hold on.
Listen.
You asked the question. He said, teach what Jesus taught. Jesus taught that in the last days there will be false prophets. And so that we should be prepared for that. And so we're talking about one of those false prophets. And one of those false prophets is Muhammad. And we're speaking about Muhammad, the torturer. Do you have a problem with Muhammad being a torturer?
Number one.
Right, so listen carefully to what we're going to say about Muhammad.
You crazy.
We can speak it.
Brother, you just said that you have a problem with torturers. So let's speak about Muhammad.
You are thirsty for Jesus.
Yes.
Let me tell you what Jesus would say to Muhammad.
Yes.
Without greed, torched people.
Repent before it's too late, my brother.
Women.
Thank you.
Go to hell.
May Lord Jesus shine his face upon you.
Shut up.
May Lord Jesus.
And who did you speak?
No. Hatun. Okay.
Get arrested.
You get. You get arrested. Okay.
Okay.
Why you touch?
So let's keep going. Let's keep going because they're trying to. It's the demons trying to interrupt what we're trying to say.
Freedom of speech. Why are you coming close to him?
Go away.
Freedom of speech.
Why you rubbish?
Okay, just calm it down a little bit. Calm it down a bit, yes?
There's no
false prophet like Muhammad, the false prophet.
Jesus is the King of Kings.
Hallelujah. Glory to Jesus. Okay, so let's keep going. Yes, let's focus. Yes. So let's continue speaking about Muhammad, the torturer for money.
Muhammad is the treasure man of Banu Nadir.
Yes.
Kinana.
Yes.
For the sake of the money, Muhammad says, torch him until he speaks.
Yes.
Torch him until he tells you where the money is.
Yes, yes.
How the torching looks like, brother? Explain to me.
Torturing. Let's look at, actually read what he actually did. Think about this. Think about this. This is what Muhammad did to this man. So, he said he kindled a fire with flint and steel on his chest until he was nearly dead.
Just a moment, I didn't understand that. So, Muhammad is torturing people.
Yes.
How is this happening?
Yes.
Muhammad, who is supposed to be the best example to mankind? Muhammad, who those Muslims follow, puts a fire on the chest of Kinana, who is the treasure man of Banu Nadir.
Yeah.
Until what fire does to your chest, brother?
What fire does my...
Fire burns your chest.
Oh, yeah,
chest.
Yeah, absolutely.
It burns your chest and it is very, very painful.
Yes.
Yet Muhammad, whom supposed to be the best example to mankind, whom supposed to be the mercy to world, is okay for his mom to torch this man for the money.
Right.
Greedy and greedy.
So essentially what you're saying is that Muhammad was driven by wealth, driven by money, not so much on upholding the word of Allah or preaching or proclaiming the truth of God's word. It was more for him to put money or to fatten up his pockets, to live a life that is a wealthy lifestyle. Is that what we're saying, sister?
We are also expanding that on saying there is no prophet in the Old Testament.
Yeah.
There is no man of the God who torched people to take their money.
Wow.
There is none. Until tortured. Not only torched, but the fire on his chest.
Yeah.
On his chest, fire burns out, and then burns the skin. It is very, very painful, guys. Very painful.
How is that a mercy?
That's a good question. Where's the Muslims now? They've disappeared. We want to know if that's a merciful act to burn someone's chest until they die, until they almost die. Is that merciful?
Peter, yeah?
I don't know. John Rambo.
Driven by greed? Is Muhammad driven for the hunger for money? He was okay for people of the book to be torched. He was okay after the torture. After he was tortured, he was all right for someone to take the sword and get rid of his head. It wasn't only torturing and saying, okay, now let's fix it. He didn't stop there. He take his head off.
Wow.
That is not a man who's supposed to be the mercy to world. That is not a prophet who's supposed to bring people to God. That is a man who is driven by hunger for money.
Greed. Yes.
And greed. Yes. For that word.
Yes. Okay. Yeah. Okay.
So let's look at another example. Is Muhammad driven by greed? Is Muhammad driven by hunger for money and power? What does Bible teaches to us about those kind of people?
Well, what Jesus Christ says himself is that. There's only one Bible, my friend.
Yeah, which version is that though?
Which version?
We are reading from the Bible, which tells us.
Multiple versions of the Bible. I'm multiple translations. I want to know which one it is.
So, I am going to tell you which Bible we will be reading from. We will be reading from the Bible, which tells us all human beings are sinners. Which tells us solution for sinful human beings is the Lord Jesus Christ. And solution has been provided by his blood on the cross. That is the Bible we will be using.
Right, okay. Yes, okay. So I read the scripture. So Jesus said, do not store up for yourself treasures on earth where moth and rust destroy, and where thieves break in and steal, but store up for yourselves treasure in heaven, where moth and rust do not destroy, and where thieves do not break in and steal. For where your treasure is, there your heart will also be. You see, that's in Matthew 6:91 through. Matthew chapter 6. And so the emphasis that Jesus placed was not on earthly things, material things, which will corrode, which will decay, which will not have eternal value. But he said, store up your treasures, heavenly treasures, where thieves cannot break in and steal. And what Jesus is teaching us is that, listen, that you can gain, you know, huge, vast amount of money, but it profits you not if you lose your soul. Or if you don't understand that your eternal worth or your eternal value or your eternal treasure is what counts. Because your body will erode and die one day, but where will your soul go to? And so when Muhammad, or this false prophet Muhammad, starts to torture and murder for money, you can see that his heart wasn't on eternal value, eternal things, but was on just earthly worth, which decays and comes to nothing at the end of the day.
Did you have breakfast today?
Did I have breakfast? I did, fortunately.
I'm sorry now, something I'm going to tell you which will make you to nearly throw up. Muhammad did not only torch this man called Kinana and killed him, after they killed this man, his wife was called Safiya. Muhammad married Safiya after torturing and killing her husband.
Wow.
That makes Muhammad double disgusting and double disturbing.
That's actually very sickly.
So Muhammad not only went against the teachings of Lord Jesus Christ by having hunger for money, because of the hunger and this greed, Muhammad tortured and killed people and then take their wives as wives to himself. Also, Muhammad went against the teachings of Lord Jesus.
Wow.
False prophet Muhammad, just false prophet.
Yeah. Wicked false prophet.
So as we saw, first Muhammad not only torched Kinana, but also Muhammad continued to torch people who in somehow converted to Islam. Story of Urara.
Yes, and so this is in Sahih Bukhari, volume 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, it says, narrated Abu Kilba, Anas said, some people of Ukil of Urania tribe came to Medina and its climate did not suit them. So the Prophet ordered them to go to the herd of camels and to drink their milk and urine as a medicine. So they went as directed, and after they became healthy, they killed the shepherd of the Prophet and drove away all the camels. The news reached the Prophet early in the morning, and he sent men in their pursuit, and they were captured and brought at noon. He then ordered to cut their hands and feet, and it was done. And their eyes were branded with heated pieces of iron. They were put in Al-Hara, and when they asked for water, no water was given to them. Abu Kilba said, those people committed theft and murder, became infidels after embracing Islam, and brought against Allah and fought against Allah and his apostle.
Let them break that down.
Break it down, sister.
So, in the 7th century,
yes.
Man, who's supposed to be mercy to world,
yeah.
Who's supposed to be the best example to mankind,
yeah.
Currently not studying medicine. He sees there are people who've got some health issues. Instead of giving them paracetamol,
yes.
On hot soup, what does Muhammad encourage those people to do? Drink camel urine.
Wow.
That probably that make those people extra ill.
Yeah, that's interesting.
That just shows how false and disturbing his teachings are.
Yeah.
Hopefully, as Muslims believe they're supposed to follow the teachings of Muhammad,
yeah.
Let's hope in 21st century they are not drinking
caramel
urine.
Wow.
That's just already disgusting. But one thing we see in the hadith happens is,
yeah.
Those people whom first looked after by Muhammad,
yeah.
By providing medicine, mm. Which is a camel urine, as they decided to leave Muhammad, what happens? Did Muhammad sit down and then tell them, go and take your freedom?
Nope.
Or what does Muhammad do? Muhammad tortures those people. Cut off their feet, that's not enough. He puts hot iron in the eyes of those people.
Yep.
Not any iron, not anything, not any toy, but hot iron in the eyes of people. And he torched them. That's not enough. He leave them without water until they die.
You know,
very merciful.
Yeah, very
merciful. Very long suffering. First, cut the heads and feet, take the eyes off with the hot iron, leave them without water. That's the Islam definition of the mercy,
yeah.
I guess.
And that's interesting. Imagine somebody comes to you and says, I have a message for you or for all mankind from God. And then their example or what they show you is by cutting off the hands, cutting off the feet of someone, branding out their eyes with iron, watching them suffer. They're begging you for mercy. They're asking you to give them water. And you say, no, you're not even going to have any water. And they say that they are anointed or they're called by God to bring you a message from him. Now, what type of God would you think that person is following? Because that's not the God of the Bible. See, because the true God of the Bible is merciful. The true God of the Bible wants you to repent and turn back. But here you have Muhammad, the false prophet, who says he comes from God, and his heart is so evil to the point that he's seen someone suffer in pain and anguish, but yet he continues on to punish them until he eventually murders them.
Can I just make a point?
Yes.
So, these things are happening in Arabia.
Yeah.
Arabia is a hot country.
Yeah.
Okay? It's hot. When I say it's hot, I mean. And when Muhammad not only cut their body parts, and then put the hot iron in their eyes, when Muhammad left those people without water in a hot Arabia, that was double suffering.
Wow.
Yet Muhammad, whom supposed to be the mercy to world, Muhammad, whom 1.84 billion Muslims are following, thinks that was all right. Torched people, chopped their body parts, took their eyes off with the hot iron and leave them without water. Watch their suffering, and he was all right with that. I don't want to follow a man called Muhammad or fake prophet called Muhammad.
No.
We look look at the Bible. Bible tells us God whom concern for the sin of mankind. God whom loved mankind. God whom saw when mankind was suffering, he did not step back or intercede to suffering to continue, but eternal Son of God came and suffered on the cross for the sinful human beings. For sinful human beings. Yet Muhammad did not only watch people to suffer, he contributed people's suffering. That's not example at all. That's not a good example. It's not even like good movie. It's a very scary movie.
Yeah, it actually reminds me of those old Italian mafia movies where they torture people for money, torture people just because of pure evil, just want to see someone suffer in pain. And you know, this type of spirit is not of God. It's a spirit, it's a demonic spirit, it's a spirit from hell. And as my sister pointed out, Jesus Christ did the exact opposite. He didn't stand back and watch people suffer and perish in their sin, but instead he came incarnate, he took on flesh and came and suffered himself. He was nailed on the cross, he was whipped, a crown of thorns was placed upon his head, and he died a gruesome, ugly death for our sins. This is the complete contrast, this is in complete conflict with the teachings of Muhammad, who's the Muslim representative and the role model for Islam, and the Christian role model for mankind. And what we would encourage you to do is look at that perfect role model, that sinless man, Jesus Christ, and what he did in our stead when we deserve hellfire.
Come and follow Lord Jesus Christ, who can give you eternal life.
Amen.
Because he is the source of eternal life.
Amen. Amen. Praise be to Jesus. Amen.